Good morning, my dear children. So let us continue our lesson, lesson number 7, time goes on. Yesterday we have completed our page number 99 in the test book, that is how old are we. I had given you a homework to find the number of full moons that have passed since you were born. I hope you all have done that homework. So please take out your test book, take page number 100. We can do page number 100 in your test book. So please be ready with your test book and pencil. Birth certificate. Here we are going to learn some of the things regarding birth certificate. Okay, look at the birth certificate of Binsi. So here given the birth certificate of Binsi. Here it is given Binsi. Here the name is given is Binsi Thomas, but in your test book you can see the name is Sudha Ramesh Chandra Trivedi. So nothing is there important regarding the name. The other things which is given, that is important. Let us see. So this is the birth certificate. See, you can see this is the birth certificate. You can see the year registered. This is to certify that this information is taken from the original record of birth, which is in the register for the year 2002 of in your textbook it is given as Balisana Panchayat. So this is a birth certificate. You all have a birth certificate. All are having a birth certificate. The purpose of birth certificate is to prove the age, because when you have born it is mandatory to make a birth certificate. In that your name, your sex, your date of birth, place of birth, everything is measured. Let us see what are the details given. Name is given, then sex, whether male or female. If it is female it will be female, if it is male it is male. If you are a boy it will be written male. If you are a girl, the sex will be written female. And the date of birth, the date on which you were born, both in number as well as in words it is given. You can see here the date of birth given is 2/5/2002, that means 2/May/2002. This is the date 2, that is 2nd. 0/5 represent the month. Month is 0/5 means 5th month is, which is the 5th month? The 5th month is May. January is the 1st month and May is the 5th month. And 2002 represent the year. So here represent the date on which this girl was born. Then the place, at which place she was born, that is given. The name of the hospital here given, it is Kadambara Hospital. In your test book you can see it is Krishna Hospital. Then name of father, name of mother, and the date of registration. The date of registration, what is the date of registration? The date of registration is the same as that of the date of birth. Then registration number, there will be a number for registration. Here given 815/02. The date of registration is 815/02. Okay. So this is the information given, and this birth certificate is issued on the date. When it is issued, the date is given here 5/8/2002. 5 is the date, that means 5th. 8 means the month, which is the 8th month. 8th month is August. So this birth certificate is issued on 5th August 2002. Okay, so as per the information given here, we have to complete this. Okay. Question number 1. See here, it is given Binsi, but in your test book it is given as Sudha. So I will say Sudha in place of Binsi. Don't get confused. It is Sudha. As in your test book, we can follow. 2/5/2002 shows that Sudha was born on 2nd, that means 2- in the year 2002. So 2 is the date. She is born on 2. And what is this 5 represent? 5 represents the month on which she was born. So which is the 5th month of the year? The 5th month of the year is May. So you have to write here May, May. and the, in the year 2002. That means Sudha was born on the 2nd of May 2002. In the year 2002, she born on May 2. Okay, so write the answer May over here. Then second question, how old will Binsi be on 2nd May 2008? So what is the date of birth? Her date of birth is, you know, 2002 is the date on which she was born. So how old will Sudha be on 2nd May 2008? So see here, she is born on 2002. So you have to deduct 2002 from 2008, because what we want to know? We want to know how many years she have completed during the year 2008 2nd May. So for that we can do like this: 2008 minus 2002. 2002 is the year on which she was born. So 2008 minus 2002. So 2008 minus 2002, how much? 8 minus 2 is 6. So she will be 6 years on 2nd May 2008. So write here 6 years. In the bracket you can write 2008 minus 2002. Moving on to the next question. How old will she be in the year 2050? So next question is, we have to find how much years she will be on the year 2052. In the year 2052, how much old she will be? For that, how we will do? Like the above question, we will do like this: 2052 minus the year in which she was born. She was born on the year 2002. So 2052 minus 2002, you will get the answer 50. So she will be 50 years old in the year 2052. Okay, then on which date will she be 8 years old? Write in numbers. So we have to find out on which year she will become 8 years old. So what we have to do? She was born on 2002. So on which year she will be 8 years old? So for that we have to add 8 with the year on which she was born. So 2002 plus 8. So 2002 plus 8, what is the year you got? You got the year 2010. So she will be 8 years old on 2nd May 2010. You have to write like this, as it is asked you to write in numbers. You have to write like this: 02-05-2010. Okay, 2-5-2010. You have to write in this format only. It is asked you to write in numbers. Don't write like 2nd May 2002. Don't write in words, write in numbers like this. So in the year 2010, she will be 8 years old. Now, moving on to the fifth question. How many months old was Sudha on 2nd August 2002? So, she was born on 2nd May 2002. So, when it is August month on the year 2002, that is, when it is 2nd August 2002, how much old she will be? That we have to find out. She was born on the month May. After May up to August, how many months are there? Let us count. From after May, June, July, August. How many months are there? There are 3 months. How many months are there? There are 3 months. So she will be 3 months old on 2nd August 2002, because she was born on May. Otherwise you can find it like this: August month, which is the number 8, and May month we will write it as 5. Okay, so 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. That way also you can find out. Otherwise you can do like this: after May count it, June, July, August. By June 2nd she will be 1 month, by July 2nd she will be 2 months, and by August 2nd 2002 she will be 3 months. So you can write here 3 months. Then how many years old she is Binsi now? You have to find out the age of Binsi now. So which is this year? The running year is 2020. Now the running year is 2020. So we have to find her age now. So how many old is Sudha? Instead of Binsya, I'm saying Sudha. Sometimes by mistake I'm saying Binsya. So but there is nothing important in the name. See the calculations. How many years old is Sudha now? So now the present year is 2020, and the year on which she was born is 2002. So you have to deduct 2020 minus 2002. So how much you will get? You will get the answer 18. 20 minus 2 is 18. So she will be 18 years old now. Okay, what is the age of Sudha now? She is 18 years old now. Then after how many months of her birth was the certificate was issued? Here you can see the certificate issuance date. The date on which certificate was issued is 5-8-2002. That is 5 August 2002. She born on 2nd May. So she born on May month, and the certificate was issued on the month of August. So after May up to August, how many months are there? There are 3 months: June, July, August. So after 3 months, the certificate was issued. So write the answer 3 months, because the certificate is issued during the month August. Okay. What is the registration number of her certificate? You can see the registration number written here. This is the registration number. Copy that here. Write 0815/02. This is the registration number of her certificate. Okay. So we have done this. Now find out. You have to find out the following. When were you born? So you have to write the when were you born, the year in which you have born. Then write your date of birth in numbers. So you have to write your date of birth in numbers like this. As written here, you have to write in numbers like this. Okay. Do you have a birth certificate? Ask your parents and make one for yourself. You all have a birth certificate. I know all are having birth certificate. For the admission in school, it is compulsory to submit the birth certificate. So it will be with your parents. So take the help of your parents and find out the details in that. And you have to fill this. There will be form number. Write the form. You have to take your birth certificate, and with the help of the parents, you have to complete this form number. What is the form number that you have read? And government of, it may be Kerala. If you are born in Kerala, this birth certificate is issued from Kerala. If you are born in Gujarat, then birth certificate will be issued from Gujarat. If you are born in Maharashtra, it will be issued by Maharashtra government. So it differs. Okay. So take your birth certificates, go through it and find out this and write down the register number and the place. Everything will be written on the birth certificate that you have to write here. Then you have to write your name here. Full name should be written here. Then sex means, if you are a girl, write female, and if you are a boy, you have to write male, mainly male. Then your date of birth. What is the date of birth that you have to write? Then place of the birth, the place where you have born, maybe the name of the hospital. Then name of father, your father's name, your full name of your father should be written here, as well as name of the mother also should be written here. Date of registration will be mentioned in your birth certificate that you have to write here, and the registration number also will be there, that also you have to write here. Then you have to write the date given in the birth certificate. The date will be the date of issue of birth certificate. So you have to do this as homework. Take the help of your parent, and you have to complete this from this. Find out. This you have to do as homework. This is the homework for today. Now moving on to the next page, you can see a calendar here. Calendar 2018. This is the calendar of the year 2018. You can see from January to December. So from this we have to complete the fill in the blanks given on the next page. Okay. Let us look at the calendar for the year 2018. First question is, how many months does a year have? So, how many months are there for a year? There will be 12 months. You know there are 12 months in a year. So, you can write the 12 months. You can write in the dash 12 months. Then, list the months which have 30 days. Some months have 30 days, some months have 31 days. And February has either 28 days, and if it is a leap year, it have 29 days. So, you have to list out the months, or you have to write the names of the months which have only 30 days. Let us see in the calendar which months have 30 days. So, see, January 31 days are there, February 28, March 31. Then see, April is having 30 days, then May 31, then June 30. After April, June, then after that you can see here September. September is having 30 days and November is also having 30 days. So, write the names of the months which have 30 days are April, June, September and November. So, April, June, September and November have 30 days. So, you have to write this. Okay. Next, list the months which have 31 days. So, next is we have to write the months which have 31 days. So, you can see here January is having 31 days. Then March is 31. May is having 31. Then July 31. August 31. Then October 31 and December also 31 days. So, write the names of the months January, March, May, July, August, October and December. All these days have, all these months have 31 days. Next, how many days does the month of February have? So, you have to find out the number of days on February as per calendar 2008. In calendar 2008, how many days are there in February? There are 28 days in February. So, you have to write here 28 days. Okay. Then, how many days make a week? How many days are there in a week? You know, from Sunday to Saturday, how many days are there? There are 7 days. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So, 7 days makes a week. So, write the answer here. 7 days. Then next question is, how many weeks are there in July? Is it true for all the months? So, you all know that 1 week means 7 days. So, in every month, there will be 4 weeks. You can see. Let us take the month July here. 1 week means 7 days. See, first week starting from Sunday to Saturday, all 7 days are there. Then next also 7 days are there. Third week also 7 days. Fourth week also 7 days. So, July have 4 weeks and 3 more days are also there. So, July have 4 weeks and 3 days. We cannot consider it as 5 weeks. Why? If 1 week, because 1 week means 7 days. So, when we consider 1 week or when we say 1 week, it must contain 7 days. But in the last week, see, only 3 days left. So, can it be considered as a week? No, it cannot be considered as a week. So, we will consider that there are 4 weeks and 3 days in the month of July. In the case of February, you can see that there are 28 days. That means exactly 4 weeks, because 1 week means 7 days. 28 days means there are 4 weeks. 28 divided by 7, otherwise 4 into 7 is equal to 28. So, in February, if it is 28 days, then we can say that it has exactly 4 weeks. If it is a leap year for February, it will have 29 days. In that case, we will say there are 4 weeks and 1 day. Okay. And in some months, there will be 30 days. In such cases, that month have 4 weeks and 2 days. And the months which have 31 days, there will be 4 weeks and 3 days. So, here, how many weeks are there in July? There are 4 weeks in July. Okay, so write 4 weeks here. Why? Because 1 week means 7 days. So July have 4 weeks and 3 days. 4 weeks completely. 1 week means 7 days. If it is having 7 days only, it is considered as a week. So July is having 4 weeks. Is it true for all the months? Yes, it is true for all the months, because all the months are having 4 weeks, because the February is having only 28 days or 29 days. So February is also having 4 weeks, and other months have 30 or 31 days. So all months have 4 weeks. Then in which month did you come to class 3? So we have started our academic session this year by April 20. I don't know whether you remember or not, as per government rules, we have started by April 20. We have got a notification that we had to start by April 20, the new session. Due to this corona pandemic situation, we have started our online classes from April onwards, April also. So you can write here April. Okay. Now make a circle on these days in the calendar. So you have to make a circle on the days given in the calendar. So first one is 26th January, next 14th November and 31st December. So see, where is 26th January? Take the calendar, take 26th January, make a circle there. Okay, next one is 14th November. So make a circle on 14th November. Then 31st December. So make a circle on 31st December. Now, is there something special about these days? Is there any import? Is these days any have any importance, or these days are any have any specialty? Yes, you know that 26th January we celebrate it as Republic Day. So write here Republic Day. 26th January is the Republic Day, and 14th November. What is 14th November? 14th November is Children's Day. It is the birthday of our Chachaji Jawaharlal Nehru. And 14th November we celebrate it as Children's Day. And what is 31st December? 31st December is the last day of the year. So write here last day of the year. Then here fill in the blanks is given here. Let us see. Fill in the blanks with the correct year. So some years are being provided here, and you have to fill this in this blanks. We have to do this considering that the current year is 2018. Here given the calendar 2018. Okay, so consider that the present year is 2018. That means year which is going on is 2018. The options given here is based on the year 2018. And we have to fill the answers accordingly, according to the options given, considering thus that this year is or current year going is 2018. You all know it is 2020, but the book is published 2 years back, as same copy has come. So it is given calendar 2018. Okay, so as per that we are going to do. Which year was it 2 years back? So 2 years back, which year it was? We are considering present year as 2018. So 2 year back, which year it was? It will be 2016. So write here 2016. Now, in which year were you in class 2? So if it is 2018 now and you are in class 3, so when you will be in class 2? You will be in the last year, that is 2017. Next, which year will be the next year? So if it is 2018 now, next year will be 2019. Then which year will come after 3 years? So after 3 years means present it is 2018, then 19, 20, 21. It will be 2021. Why we have done this? Because the option given here is as per considering that the year is 2018 and the calendar given there is the calendar of year 2018. On the basis of that we have to do this. Okay, actual date when we calculate as per the present condition, it here the answer will change because the present year is 2020. Okay, so you have to do the complete the birth certificate given here on page number 101. That is the homework for today. So Let us wind up the session for today. Thank you.